lot of dancing. But that's how I was taught. Amen? Luke 9. This was a part of the transfiguration. And if you notice, Jesus only took Peter, James, and John. See, everybody can't go. Everybody can go. Amen? Now, he let us all, but everybody can't handle certain things. Amen? And that's just the gist of it. That's just the gist of it. So he took him up there, and he's my favorite man again, Peter, starting at verse 9, I mean, chapter 9, verse 35. Go up to verse 33. And it came to pass, and they departed from him. And Peter said unto Jesus, Master, it is good for us to be here. Now, it is good for us to be here. Amen. And let us make three tabernacles, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah. Not knowing what he said. Amen. While he thus spake, there came a cloud and overshadowed them. And they feared as they entered into the cloud. I love this. And there came a voice out of the cloud saying, This is my son. Hear him. And when the voice was passed, Jesus was found alone. Hallelujah. And they kept their clothes and told no man those days, any of those things which they had seen. The reason why I brought that out is when you're doing right, your father will validate you. Amen? Your father will validate you. Amen? And he says, now hear him. See, that's why I put my ears up. The Bible tells me I'm supposed to have the tongue of have the ears of the Lord and the tongue of the Lord so I know how to speak a word in season to them who are weary. You know, my dad taught me that, and I've been doing that. See, I come to church now. He told me enough scripture and enough places how to find it. Now I come to church and learn how to keep changing. So when I hear him, I grab something. If it's just one thing that I can walk out with, I'm changing. Yeah, y'all hear me, y'all, there you go. It's not a fact. For me, there you go. That's what I need. That's why I've been meditating all week. So when I get to church, I get confirmation from my father, and I just say, there you go. So that lets me know I'm walking in the right path with the Lord. Because if my daddy's confirming it, then I know I'm right. Amen? He can't miss it. Because he told the shepherd of the house the same thing. I'm on the right path. So I'm going to scream, there you go, and keep on screaming it. Amen? Tell you. Amen. But let's look at what Jesus was trying to tell him, because when God validated him as his son, and then he said, now listen to him. Let's look at what he told him to listen to. Y'all ready for this? Go to John chapter 14. John chapter 14. Starting at verse 15. And this is what they're supposed to hear. Amen? This is Jesus speaking. If you love me, keep my commandments. If you love me, keep my commandments. This is my son. Hear him. And he tells him, if you love me, keep my commandments. Amen? Do you love him today? Then keep his commandments. Amen? Go to John 15. Let's look at some more he told him what to do. Starting with verse 11. These things have I spoken unto you, that my joy might remain in you, and that your joy might be full. Hallelujah. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. Greater love has no man than this, that the man lay down his life for his friend. You are my friends. If you do whatsoever I command you, henceforth I called you, not as servants, for the servant knoweth not what his Lord doeth or practices. But I have called you friends, for all things have I heard of my Father, I have made known unto you. And here's one of my favorite scriptures, verse 16. You have not chosen me, but I have chosen you, and ordained you. There's an identity right there. He's ordained you, amen? And ordained you that you should go and what? Bring forth fruit that your fruit should remain, that whatsoever shall you ask of the Father in my name, he may give it to you. Amen? Amen. I love that. Amen. Let's go to 1 John. 1 John chapter 4. But we got to listen to him. And again, one of the key words, every time Jesus, I poke up my ears every time I hear that word hearken. You know, years ago, a bishop taught that and he said, the word hearken just didn't mean listen. Are you willing to listen with an intent to change? No, we always should be listening with an intent to change. Every time the word is going forth, we ought to be listening with an intent to change. I'm even learning that my daughter, as young as she is, can tell me something if I'm listening and I have an intent to change. I'm learning that a lot of times when I learn to listen, I learn more, I receive more, amen, and I get more. But if I'm always dominating the conversation, if I'm always the one who has to be the focus, I'm losing. I don't know it all. I don't know it all. And I can't do it by myself. Amen? I need you too. I need you. You need me. The Bible says we've all been given a measure of faith. So I got to take my measure of faith and help you in yours. Where I'm lacking, you need to use your measure of faith to help me in mine. That's the way the fellowship works. And that's how we become unified as one. Because each of us is using the same measure of faith to help the other get over. Amen? Amen. 1 John 4. It's growing up time. Amen? It wasn't an easy process, but praise God, there's a process that's working in it. Because he said, being confident of this very thing, that which I began in you, I will perform it unto the day of Christ. Amen? And he's going to do it. He's going to do it. 1 John chapter 4, starting at verse 20. 4 and 20 says this: if any man say, I love God, and hate his brother, he is a liar. For he that loveth not his brother, whom he has seen, how can he love God whom he has not seen? Amen? And this commandment have we from him, that he who loved God, love his brother also. Amen? Amen. Sons may fail. Sons may fail, but should never quit. You may fail, but you should never quit. God has grace for those who fail, but not for those who quit. Amen? And I'm a walking example of that. When you quit, nobody, not even God, can help you. Are you listening to me? If you quit, you will never know what could have been. Spiritual growth is neither a function of time or learning, but it is a function of obedience. Are you hearing me? Spiritual growth is neither a function of time or learning, but it is a function of obedience. Go with me to Hebrews chapter 12, and we're almost there. Amen. Hebrews chapter 12. Starting at verse 8, Hebrews 12 and 8, it says, but if you be without discipline, chastisement, whereof all are partakers, see, everybody's a partaker of this,